Paul did not say, judge yourself first or condemn yourself. He said, examine yourself. Are you Apache? Are you a dead dog? If so, accept it. Refrain from them and the gate is open for you. That's all. All Paul. Oh, what Paul added to what Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John wrote
was these things.
And only way in a Paul decan.
But nowadays, when we read further in the Corinthians, the Bible says,
if you
die unwealthily, people say, I am not wealthy. No, that's not what the Bible says.
And that's not the Bible.
The way you die with the Lord must be worthy.
And also,
he didn't say you are not worthy. King David, who am I?
When
you come to your table, I am not wealthy. I'm just a dead dog. Oh, King David, please, I am not worthy to be here. But Jesus made you worthy.
Yes.
On that cross, when he said it was finished, that day made you worthy. But the dying must be worthy dying. Don't see it as things we bought from Aldi. Or from Lidl, or it's just everything that everyone wants to do. That time, we are making the dying dinner on
words.
I bring my message one
minute.
It's the Last Supper. But where from Lodiba?
Lodiba,
where from Ziba?
Ziba,
where from this story? One thing, baby, I have not realized yet. Go to the last verse of the same verse you are reading.
Last verse.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
God is wonderful.
Amen.
2 Samuel chapter 9, verses 13. The same chapter we are reading. Verse 13 says, so Mephibosheth dwell in Jerusalem, for he did eat. What did he say? He did eat continually at the king's table and was lame at his feet. Of course, did he? Every day he ate.
Yeah, no, did he?
When he was back to school, he used to say this fasting song. Now I am eating. Every day I eat. Yesterday, tomorrow. That's why you know what I used to say. Now I am eating. Every day I will eat. Yesterday, instead of saying that, I say I eat it. Amen. So the Bible says he ate.
Bible
says
ODD.
He ate.
Odiba.
But jump to one verse earlier. Verse 12 said, and Mephibosheth had a young son. When you read the Bible well, read it well. Verse 12 says, Mephibosheth had a son whose name was
Micah.
And all that dwelt in the house of Ziba were servants unto Mephibosheth. When he was Lodiba, did he have any son? When he was cast away to no pastor, did he have a son? But he was still a cripple. What made the difference? The king's table. The king's table made a difference. But when he sat down to eat, that dinner changed his life. Oh, it changed his life. That even when he was still a cripple, the beautiful man in Jerusalem, they did not see his cripple condition. Oh, they said, haven't you seen me? I'm passing by. Haven't you seen me? I'm fair in complexion. I have everything. What do you want?
I don't want to.
Careful, man, make you selection. Can you imagine? The Bible said he had a son. How can a cripple have a son? When I was thinking about this, I don't know, Papa, this thing, I have to ask it here. Why is that when God is giving me revelations, at awkward moments, sometimes I'm baffled, sometimes I'm pacing, but not time that I'm praying. Why? I'll come to the answer later. I don't know when God speaks to you. But God referred me to Acts chapter 3. Peter and John were going to the temple to pray, the Bible says they met a man who was lame. L-A-M-E, lame. That same lame is what we found in the Old Testament. And Luke was a medical doctor. Luke, so when a doctor said headache, you're not satisfied about. My people just fallen. What's when the usual fall? He breaks something in the spinal cord. That is why he was lame down. Those people who are in the wheelchairs, that they are no sensitivity in their destiny. It's from here down. You understand? So if you are here down, it affects your front. So your front cannot get up. So how come this lame man who was affected can have a riser to make a sound? That tells me that there's power in the table of God. If you are a man, you've been dodging the Lord's Supper, stop dodging it. If your finances are crippled, stop dodging it. If there are difficulties in your life, stop dodging the Lord's Supper. Come to Christ and say, Christ, I have accepted myself. I have come to see that it was my grandmother who let me fail, and I became people at my feet. That's how I have assigned myself to see. So my condition is crippled. These are what are crippling me most. Those things are in Galatians 5. When you go and read them and say, Lord, this is a crippling me. If you can turn Mephibosheth's life around, for a cripple who was living in Lodibar, that village, no car passes there. As for my hometown, keep quiet. My hometown, only two cars pass there. When the car passes, and you miss it, you have to wait for another 8 hours. And if one of them is broken, you have to wait until the next day. My hometown, those days, but now no more. Come and see. Now a small landing. But as for Lodibar, not even a car. Even Charles don't pass there. This man was hidden there. No communication. No pastor. A death sentence. Aquarius. That is why he was damned. You and I, we have been damned the same. Broken heart has crippled us so much that we can't even see.